This is the thing with wandering around London using photography as a hobby. Sometimes you line up your shots to be all nicely framed. Other times you bump into random models on the street. And sometimes you just want to take a photo of a bin with a really bokered out background. Hello, hello, and welcome to London. It's a little bit windy, so I'm hiding in St. James Park where it's a little bit less windy to record the intro bit, but let's just go. What the heck kind of dog is this? This is nice and simply going to be a POV video with the XT4, the 56mm lens, taking photos of stuff because I don't have a plan. There is a parakeet. Look at this parakeet munching on whatever fruit that is in amongst all of the pigeons. Get out of my shot, pigeons. You're not as pretty as the parakeet. Oh, and here is a squirrel. What is happening? Why is there so much nature occurring here? Do you want this camera? Do you want to have a sniff? Little sniffy sniff. One more try in the sun. Oh, look at that sunny squizzle. There were so many photo bobbing pigeons in that. I felt like a little bit of a Disney princess, not gonna lie. This shot here of this building being framed by the London Eye. I always love this. This is a very touristy shot to take, but it is pretty. Is there a better way to do street photography than just following someone in a really cool hat and taking photos of them existing in their really cool hat? I feel like a weirdo now that I've said that out loud, but the photo is of a hat wearing man. I'm heading towards the river, which may be a bad idea because windy, but we shall see. Westminster Alley in this light looks absolutely stunning. I've just taken a few photos from across the road over there. It's a little bit busy in the foreground, but you know, you can't say no to this lighting. And another shot here just of the left tower with it. It just looks like it's painted a different color on the left than it is on the right. That light is amazing. Looks like it's time for Tall Ben to catch those rays instead. I like this with it on the right side of the frame, looking off to the left, the clouds behind it, the fact that it's perpetually 12 o'clock. They nearly fixed it. Well done, almost. There's something about this cone. I don't know what it is. It's probably the twinkly bokeh in the background, that lovely sunsetty sky, but this cone looks magnificent, doesn't it? I really think it does. Am I mad? Help. Well, I just met a man named Marcus, who I took a bunch of photos of. I have no idea if they're any good, but they're scrolling through the screen right now. Some of them I used the Moment Cinebloom filter for because I had it in my pocket. The sunset looked really cool, so I thought it would look cooler with the Moment. I don't know if it did. I panicked. Help. Marcus, if you're watching this video, thank you for putting up with my nonsense for like 10 minutes. I don't know how to take photos of models, so I just made it up as I went along. I hope you liked the photos. If you didn't, it's perfectly fine too. I don't know what it is, but I always like this angle on the London Eye pods. It just makes it look a little bit more space age to me, and I have no idea why, because it doesn't. Here goes the little tire boat off into the glowy sunset. Let's get a nice little action shot of that zipping along in the water. It's time for photos of shapes, such as this circle. Look at the beautiful glow behind the circle. Isn't it magnificent? I don't know why. I really like that. I started taking this photo as a joke. Now I'm going to spend the rest of the evening getting way too close to things to see if they look cool. Thank you, little wheel, for your service. Whee! This grotty, graffiti-covered bin with people walking in the background. If you were smarter than me, you could call this social commentary. But I don't really know what that means, so I can't. Look at St. Paul's there with that beautiful orangey colour in the sky, framed between this lamppost and this crane. That might not be a good photo, but I really like it. That is sometimes how it be. You kind of just take a photo and sometimes it turns out good and other times it does not. But the important thing is you took the photo. I think that's the important thing. This is the thing with wandering around London using photography as a hobby. Sometimes you line up your shots to be all nicely framed. Other times you bump into random models on the street. And sometimes you just want to take a photo of a bin with a really bokered out background. This is a nice tunnel. The way it leads off into the distance is really cool. This would be a great spot for a model. Our model in this instance is this runner that happened to be going by. But if you got a proper model, it might be cool. Maybe. Here we have St. Paul's framed nice and simply between two cranes. Nice. I like that. That is a composition. It's time for my favorite, the shot I take every time I'm here, the classic bank skyline. That is so cool. I love this shot, and I especially love it in classic negative. So which do you prefer, my edit or the classic negative? Ooh, which one? I've not noticed this framing before, but if you shoot through this railing, you get a lovely shot where each cluster of buildings has its own little segment, and you've got this kind of like an iron colorless rainbow. Does that make sense? No. It's a bit of a moody frame, but this brutalist building here, all concretey and jaggedy and edgy, with that curvy building behind it just filling the frame in this super moody lighting, looks awesome. Well, it looks awesome to me. I hope that the photo does it justice, but I don't know, that's kind of up to you to decide rather than me. I know that this is just a marketing slogan for whatever Warner's Gins is, but room to grow is a great message, just by the way. Just, you've always got room to grow. Also, the buildings are framed nicely between the sign and the plants here. I didn't notice that. Thank you, room to grow sign. You've helped me yet again. If I take a little step back, that is quite a spicy frame. A cool message and a cool shot. What more can a blue box offer you? Now I'm wondering about what I've ever bought that came in a blue box that offered me more. What comes in blue boxes? Job lots of cheese and onion crisps. That would help me. I don't know what it would help me do. Get fat. Yes. What were we talking about? Photography. That's it. You've always got room to grow. Is that how this started? What on earth does my brain do? Millennium Bridge and St. Paul's. Is there a more fun place to take photos in London? This is absolutely stunning. My favorite is this leading line shot here, especially at nighttime, because you've got the lights either side on the bridge, and especially with this moody, moody sky. But if we use this glass wall here, we can get quite a nice reflection shot. I say quite a nice, I think that runner just farted at me. I think it's a nice reflection. I don't know, like, if it's as good as the normal shots of it, but it's fun to try something different. Now, I think I'm gonna stay on this side of the river today and just walk up to Tower Bridge and then head home. That's a good plan. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna take a photo of you, Shard. You haven't escaped me yet. You know what? We haven't taken enough photos of St. Paul's. Let's just get one more of it poking its head over that building, because all them clouds. Ooh, them clouds. Them clouds are detailed and beautiful and fluffy, and I would eat them. We have made it to our first shot of the Shard, of the video, and, you know, honestly, at this point, even I have to admit that this is way too much glow for any practical purpose, but for the purposes of, oh my gosh, look at it, how freaking cool is that, it's just spot on. Like, it looks like the bottom of the frame is on fire. I don't think this is anything just yet, but it looks like it's going to be a little shopping corridor thing, and when it opens, it's going to look amazing. Hang on, there's a fence in your way. I really like this, the little pier here. Like, we get a nice little landscape shot of that, and it glowing, and the reflection on the water, and it's just, ooh, it's so pretty. It's not a proper tourist walk around London until you've taken a photo of Tower Bridge, and using this lovely shiny wall in front of me for a nice little reflection seemed like the right way to do it. This is another one of those tourist spots that I will keep coming back to, because you've got this lovely leading line that goes right the way to Tower Bridge. Just, or at least a tower of Tower Bridge. Half of Tower Bridge. 0.5 Tower Bridges. You do also have the Shard in this direction, but I don't really have the right lens for it, but I will get this shot with people walking in the bottom of the frame and all the glowy lights in the top half. Here's what I can get of the Shard. There you go. That's what the top of it looks like. I don't know what that building is. I'm guessing like apartments or something, but look at it glowing, glowingly in the sky between the two buildings, looking all moody, but glowy. Yes. Building. Good. There's a lovely romantic moment happening here with these two people sat on the wall, and Tower Bridge behind them, I think, is probably the best framing. I mean, it's romantic until they slip and fall in the river. Then it's just cold and wet and eaten by swans. That's what happens if you fall in the Thames. I take back what I just said. The city behind them, that's the one. Just a properly lovely little moment. And I think that's why I really like photography, because I like capturing those lovely little moments. And also the shard. I like taking photos of the shard, especially with weird framing like this fence. And the squirrel from earlier. That's not here right now, but I enjoyed taking the photo of the squirrel. It is getting windy on this river. Is it a sign? Is the wind telling me I should go home? One more shot of the shard. One more of these like layered shots where you've got the old in the foreground, the new in the background, the Tower of London and the shard. Two very iconic things to end the video on. That's right, it's nighttime and it's past my bedtime. So, it's time to inspect the damage that the wind has done to my hair. Not too bad. Thank you very much for watching. It's been a little while since I last got out to shoot just a normal wandering around POV. So, I hope you enjoyed it because I certainly did. So, thank you very much for watching, but the video is now over. So, goodbye. Bye. Goodbye. Thank you again so much for watching. Yes, I did forget to record this part again, so I am recording it in my house. There is a cat in his little cat tunnel. Off he has disappeared. Put a comment below. Tell me what your favourite photo was, if you had a favourite. If you didn't have a favourite and they were all terrible, put a comment telling me that too. See you next time. Bye.